Get ready to match the stars. Gary Murgoff, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Riley, Susan Sullivan, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Buller Fox as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rammer!
Would you believe there is a moth flying around back there?
A moth?
A moth. Or as what's-his-name said in the movie, a myth.
A myth.
You didn't hurt it, did you?
No, I tried to, but it got
you
away.
You sure it's not a fairy?
Kill that moth there.
No. What are you looking at me for? That voice coming out of this head, are you kidding?
You're going to stay the whole week, are you?
Oh, I hope so.
Oh, good. Let's say hello to our two players, Sandy Fenmore and Sergeant Dick Harris over here. Now, Sandy's a current champ, right? How much money have you won? I've forgotten.
$600.
$600. And she's being challenged by the good sergeant here. And he's had both of his questions. He's a match three. And you've got one question to go. So you're kind of in the driver's seat here. All you have to do is match one, and you will have won your second game. Tune in a moment or so and see how this turns out after this match.
It was canned whistle.
What?
It was a canned whistle.
No, it wasn't. No, wait a minute. I got to settle something here. Madam, would you do that again? Yeah, by Jove. I got a lady whistler. One more. Now, wait a minute. Wait till we get a camera on you. I couldn't believe my ears.
Well, Mr. Mack, I've been whistling ever since my
kids were... Johnny, the least you can do for Johnny is get her a taxi. Okay, well, that's very good. I don't know why she's just very excited about the whole thing, as you must be up here, too, because we're going to finish this game now. Sandy, are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, the sergeant's got his fingers crossed there, and this is all she has to do is match one. Three of you play and three of you don't.
Well, why don't we'll play?
All right, would the three of you like to play?
Sure.
Oh, all right. Sure. Would you like to lay out this?
Oh, there.
Yeah,
there.
Okay.
There.
You don't. Ugly Edna is so ugly.
How ugly is she?
I'm going to tell you how ugly she is. When the photographer had her smile at the birdie blinked.
What the?
That's how ugly, ugly Edna was. When the photographer had her smile at the birdie blinked. Okay. Now, Sandy. Ugly Edna is so ugly, when the photographer had her smile at the birdie blinked.
The birdie threw up?
The birdie barfed, she said.
Oh, bird barfed.
A bird barfed, right. Put it right in the middle of the garden. What'd you say to that, Susan Sullivan?
Well, after he barfed,
What? What? Wait a minute, well, don't start talking until I have shoved the mic in your face.
Now, what's
going on?
We have the wrong people playing here. Somebody's made an error, and we have part of the panel playing.
I see.
We'll throw this question out. I'll take this away from you.
Yes.
And here are two.
All right.
And you can have her pick one of the, Sandy can pick one of these two.
All right.
And we'll go on from there.
All right.
These are two second round questions.
You're fired.
Oh, good. As I respect our producer, ladies and gentlemen.
Have we changed this so that you've changed the lights,
yep,
have you?
We're
so
not
that
the correct play ones. And they're going to play.
Oh, they're the ones. All right. They'll be playing up there. All right, Sandy, you have a choice of either. You want that one. All right, I'll just stick this one here, and I'll read it for all concerned. Nanook the Eskimo said, "It's tough living in an igloo. Not only are the walls made out of ice, but inside even the blank is made out of ice." Just the three of you.
Yes,
Nanook the Eskimo. It's tough living in an igloo. Not only are the walls made out of ice, but inside even the blank is made out of ice. Gary's finished.
Yes, well, I'm doing my best here. Who was that masked rider who was here a moment ago?
That was Iris Gooch.
What does he do?
He's the head man here.
Really?
He's the boss man, yes.
What crazy for me.
All right.
He dresses so casually.
Really? Great.
Okay, Sandy. All you have to do is match one celebrity, and you will have won your second game. Nanook the Eskimo said, "It's tough living in an igloo. Not only are the walls made out of ice, but inside even the blank is made out of ice."
The toilet.
Sergeant, there is hope. The trip may not have been in vain. She said, the toity. What do you say?
I'm sorry. I'm afraid your hope just went in the toity.
Toity! Come on down, my dear Sandy, and stand over there on the adhesive tape while I shake his hand here. A pleasure meeting you.
It's been fun.
And we've got marvelous gifts for you, Sergeant. Sergeant, you're walking out when I'm talking to you. What is that? Oh, there you go. Goodbye, Sergeant. So now, Sandy, you picked up another $100. You got $700, and now you come to the big money. And shall we get right to it?
Yes.
We pulled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Unblank. Remember, you get $500 if you match the answer they gave most frequently, $250 if you match their second most frequently given response, and $100 for the third most popular. And you can call on anyone you want here for a little help.
Okay, Richard.
Well, I know you are a married lady, but I will say, undress.
Undress.
Now, my answer is...
Don't listen to him now. Okay. Don't pay any attention to him.
Okay, Gary.
Uncola.
Charles. I say un-American.
Thank you, Senator McCarthy. Okay. You got un-American, un-cola, and undress. Take your pick.
Un-cola.
You want un-cola? Well, I guess the audience thinks you made the right selection. We'll find out right now. We got a little un-cola up there. Let's begin at the bottom and reveal a $100 ticket. Un-American is Charles' answer.
Thank you, people.
Thank you, Senator. Okay, back to Iowa for you. Now, let's see what we've got under the $250 number. Undecided is a good response,
isn't it? That's also un-American.
Right. Last chance for un-cola. Slide it, Earl. Oh! Yeah, you got it. Very good. Yeah. Can't win them all, son. Very good, my dear. You picked up another $500. You got $1,200 now. You're getting into the big money there. Now you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. How about that? How's that grab you?
$5,000. Okay.
Who do you want to try here?
I will try Richard.
Richard.
I'll say Andreas.
Yeah.
I'll keep saying it. I'll get lucky one day.
How soon they forget.
Would you face Fairfax Avenue, please? There. Okay, here we go. It's worth $5,000. Get your ESP going, flowing over to Richard. Pinball blank. Pinball blank.
Sorry, I didn't hear that.
Okay, Sandy, we ask you... You don't have to hear it, Brett.
Oh.
Don't interrupt.
Oh, I'm sorry.
He is a very...
Give us an answer which you think will match his, if you would please, now. Pinball blank.
Machine?
Machine is her answer. All right, she says pinball machine will match you with the $5,000. Richard, what do you say to that?
Do you remember the film with Elton John? The big hit record, too.
What was that called?
Pinball Wizard.
Oh, yeah. Because
you need a machine.
Okay, you got $6,200.
I don't have $6,000.
Yes, you do have $6,000. Indeed, you do. And while you and your sister are celebrating, we're going to spin these messages for America. How do you do? Listen, would you like to greet another player now?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's say hello to Lynn Rafkin. Where are you from, Lynn, and all that?
I'm from Palos Verdes, where I sell real estate. I'm married and have a 7-year-old daughter.
Anything else?
Kokosi. Does that mean anything to you?
Kokosi.
Right.
Kokosi.
Oh, is that it?
Yeah, it means how are you?
That's right.
In Serbo-Croatian. You speak that language?
No.
Obviously.
Someone
put you up to that,
Very little.
Yeah, well, I thank you for asking. Okay, here we go. Bing, there you go. Lynn, you may have A or B.
A.
A. Okay, Lynn.
I got
it. Nice that she thought of it.
I think that's marvelous. The answer to that.
Rude and
here. Coco si, that means how are you? And the answer is Dobro hvala lepa. I'm well, thank you.
Que pasa?
Nah, shut up. Now listen to this, Lynn. Bernie is such a super salesman, he once sold a frilly lace dress to blank. Now, this happens to be a terrific question, so I don't want any groans from this audience. Just think about it for a second.
Super salesman.
Super salesman, certainly.
Sure.
It's very easy. I put it down there now. Come on, guys, start without you.
I got it.
Hello, little girl. Okay. Bernie is such a super salesman, Lynn. He once sold a frilly lace dress to...
a man.
Well, that's the general idea. We were hoping you were going to be a little more specific than that. Say something like Rock Hudson or whatever there. But here we go. No, we're not. What do you say?
I never thought of him.
Well, let's see.
What do you mean, man?
Any strong, powerful, tall, good-looking guy with muscles.
Who would you say? John Wayne, of course.
John Wayne is a very good one.
Excellent.
Absolutely. Perfect choice. What do you say?
I can't think of a thing.
Your mom.
I say Rosie Grier.
Rosie Grier is another good one.
Wouldn't he look cute
big
in the dress?
Yes, he would. Frilly and lacy.
John Wayne.
Wainovich. Okay, Lynn. Aren't they terrific? What do you say, Susan?
I said Richard Nixon.
Oh!
Honey.
We're getting some diversified responses here. Bernie, such a super salesman, once sold a frilly lace dress to...
Muhammad Ali!
Yeah!
He could get away with it.
Well, he stung him like a bee. What do you say?
They're all wrong.
They are.
You said a super salesman,
right?
Which means he sells to super people. So I said he sold it to Superman.
Well, your mind is weird.
Oh, to blind people.
Okay, Lynn.
Test on this at the lab.
Now, Sandy.
She's having a breakdown. Try to be kind to her.
Right on camera. The gossip columnist said, "I've known Zsa Zsa so long, I knew her when she only had one blank." That's how long I've known Zsa Zsa.
Oh, I got it.
What, that showbiz? Put it in the slot. Let's go.
Or that.
You got it.
Presto. The gossip columnist said, "I've known Zsa Zsa so long, I knew her when she only had one blank.
Husband."
Okay, she said husband. What do you say?
You see, she's only had ever one husband at a time.
Right.
But once she only had one diamond.
Only one diamond. That's good. Never. We're probably going to get a lot of good answers here. What do you say?
I'm going to kill myself, but first I'm going to kill Charles Nelson Reilly. I wrote hubby.
Hubby,
right? He said, wrong.
So what'd you
do? So I wrote diamond. He said, wrong. You said, hurry up, so I left it in the slot. Otherwise, you would have had husband.
Oh.
Oh, I'm sick of you.
Would you say it's a little... Would you say she's expressed just a mite of hostility? Charles?
Now, what is she noted for most?
Who, Zsa Zsa?
Yes.
Her boobs?
No, I don't think so. Divorce. She only had one. No one had one divorce.
Oh.
That's her rottenest answer.
Kakushnik, komunya, chinyabu.
If he wanted to sound divorce, why did he give her husband?
Susan Sullivan, would you straighten this out here? I've known Zsa Zsa so long, I knew her when she only had one blank.
Husband.
There's one for Sandy. Now, I happened to peek at Richard as he was writing his answer. He will now give us the definitive, all-time terrific answer to this question.
Well, because this woman really knew her way back, right?
Right, an all-time friend.
Yeah, she knew Zsa Zsa when she only had one judge.
That's it.
Very good.
When she only had one job.
I wish I thought of that.
You didn't think of that.
No.
Then. Okay.
Could what say did one you think chin. Of? I said.
What did she say?
Oh. Someday, you're going to be a middle-aged lady.
Not I.
Tomorrow morning.
She only had one wedding ring.
Only one wedding ring. Okay. So there we are. At the end of round one, we have 1-0 in favor of the current champion, and round two follows round one. Isn't that interesting? But first, then. And here we go with round two. Lynn, you may have A or B.
I'll try A again, please.
A again. Kojak said. He says, yesterday I was attacked by Indians. When they saw I had no hair on my head, they scalped the hair from my blank. Terrific. I'm proud of all of you. Write it down. Okay. All right, Lynn Rafkin. Kojak said, yesterday I was attacked by Indians. And when they saw I had no hair on my head, they scalped the hair from my blank.
From his chest.
Chest, she said. You seem to be disappointed in her response. You weirdos! Hello, Gary.
I recently worked with Telly, you know, on the Battle of the Celebrity Stars, you know, it's Olympic events for celebrities, and I saw him in the locker room.
Yeah.
And I happen to know that they... Legs is my answer.
Oh, I bet that hurt, didn't it? All right. What do you say, Brett?
Hi, Han. I said they took the hair from his little chair.
What do you say?
I say in your chino moon. El Chesto.
El Chesto. Okay, so we have two for you so far, Lynn. Now, Susan, Kojak said when they saw the Indian saw I had no hair on my head, they scalped the hair from my...
Well, I happen to know he has no hair on his chest. Don't ask me how.
Oh.
I said it anyway.
Oh, you said it. Oh. Come to my dressing room later and bring your notebook. What do you say, Richard?
A chest.
Chest. That's 4 for her. 4-1 is the score. And now Joyce.
Oh, shoot.
What's wrong?
I didn't say that.
You don't like that?
Well, she didn't say that.
I didn't say it.
Oh, you didn't say chest?
No.
What'd you say?
Well, I was thinking of every other place that had hair.
Oh, really?
I said armpit.
That answer is the pits. Okay.
You know him too, huh?
So here we are.
Not that way.
4-1 is the score. And now, Sandy, 3 to tie and 4 to win. Ready for it? Here we go. You don't play. Right, you're the only one. Hey, they just invented a living bra made out of cowhide. Yes. Touch it and it blanks. Aren't you sorry you're not playing?
What happened?
Living bra made out of cowhide. Touch it and it blanks.
I like living that kind of question. It's simple, it's direct, and it's to the point. And it's tricky to make a mistake.
Okay. Okay, Sandy. They just invented a living bra made out of cowhide. Touch it and it...
Moose.
Moose is good. Oh, it's such a big production number here going on. Moose is simple, straightforward, direct answer.
But they don't know how to spell it.
Oh. Moose. 4-2 the score. All right, let's see if we get a moo out of you.
I know how to milk a cow, and they always go, moo!
Right. I get a moo out of you. What do you say? What took you so long?
But just explain.
I was going
to
write utter cow udders.
Cow udders?
So when you touch it, it utters sweet nothings, and I didn't like that.
Really?
And now you asked, and I told you, moo! Adorable answer. If you sat next to her for 4 years, you'd try to do something too.
I love it when you're angry.
Well, I do get tough.
Okay, Sue, Richard, what did you say there?
Maybe we should let Charles go to celebrity bowling as he wishes.
Moo.
Moo.
Hang around over here. We're going to say goodbye to Lynn Rafkin. It was a pleasure meeting you. We've got some gifts for you together with our thanks. Lynn Rafkin,
thank
while
you.
We're spinning her off, spin these messages just for you. Next time we're together, these are the celebrities you'll see on this very stage.
Orson Bean, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Mary Wicks, Richard Dawson, and Betty White.
Thank you all. Gene Rayburn here. Join us next time for Match Game 76. Goodbye.
Say, undress.
Undress.
Now, my
don't listen to him now. Don't pay any attention to him.
Okay, Gary?
Uncola.
Uncola.
Charles?
I say un-American.
Thank you, Senator McCarthy. Okay. You got un-American, Uncola, and undress. Take your pick.
I'll have Uncola.
You want Uncola? Well, I guess the audience thinks you made the right selection. We'll find out right now. We got a little Uncola up there. Let's begin at the bottom and reveal a $100 ticket. Un-American is Charles' answer.
Thank you, people.
Thank you, Senator. Okay, back to Iowa for you. Now, let's see what we've got under the $250 number. Undecided is a good response.
That's also un-American.
Right. Last chance for Uncola. Slide it, Earl. Oh! Yeah, you got it. Very good. Can't win them all, son. Very good, my dear. You picked up another $500. You got $1,200 now. You're getting into the big money there. Now you're going to play for 10 times that amount or $5,000. How about that? How's that grab you?
$5,000. Okay.
Who do you want to try here?
I will try Richard.
Richard.
I'll say Andreas.
Yeah.
I'll keep saying it. I'll get lucky one day.
How soon they forget.
Would you face Fairfax Avenue, please? There. Okay, here we go. It's worth $5,000. Get your ESP going, flowing over to Richard. Pinball blank. Pinball blank.
Sorry, I didn't hear
that. Okay, Sandy. We ask you... You don't have to hear it, Brett. Oh. Don't interrupt.
Oh, I'm sorry.
He is a very...
Give us an answer which you think will match his, if you would, please.
Match his.
Well, Mr. Mack, I've been whistling ever since my
first
work.
Johnny, the least you can do for Johnny is get her a taxi. Okay, well, that's very good. I don't know why she's just very excited about the whole thing, as you must be up here, too, because we're going to finish this game now. Sandy, are you ready?
I'm ready.
All right, the sergeant's got his fingers crossed there, and this is all she has to do is match one. Three of you play and three of you don't.
Well, but why don't we... We'll play. All right,
would the three of you like to play?
Sure.
Oh, all right, sure. Would you like to lay out
this? Oh,
yeah. Yeah, okay.
You don't.
Ugly Edna is so ugly.
I'm
going to tell you how ugly she is. When the photographer had her smile at the birdie blanked.
What the...
That's how ugly, ugly Edna was. When the photographer had her smile at the birdie blanked. Okay. Now, Sandy. Ugly Edna is so ugly, when the photographer had her smile at the birdie blanked.
The birdie threw up?
The birdie barfed, she said.
Oh, a bird barf.
A bird barf, right. Put it right in the middle of the garden. What'd you say to that, Susan Sullivan?
Well, after he barfed, he...
What? What? Wait a minute. Well, don't start talking until I shove the mic in your face.
Now, what is it?
What's going on?
We have the wrong people playing here. Somebody's made an error, and we have the wrong part of the panel playing.
I see.
We'll throw this question out. I'll take this away from you.
Yes.
And here are two.
All right.
And you can have her pick one of the... Sandy can pick one of these two.
All right.
And we'll go on from there.
All right.
These are two second-round questions.
You're fired.
Oh, good. As I respect our producer, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, okay.
Have we changed this so that you've changed the lights,
yeah,
have you?
We're
so
not
that
the correct play, ones. And they're going to play.
Oh, they're the ones. All right. Oh, they'll be playing up there. All right, Sandy, you have a choice of either. You want that one. All right, I'll just stick this one here, and I'll read it for all concerned. Nanook the Eskimo said, "It's tough living in an igloo. Not only are the walls made out of ice, but inside even the blank is made out of ice." Just the three of you.
Nanook
the Eskimo. It's tough living in an igloo. Not only are the walls made out of ice, but inside even the blank is made out of ice. Gary's finished.
Yes, well, I'm doing my best here. Who was that masked rider who was here a moment ago?
That was Iris Cooch.
What does he do?
He's the head man here.
Really?
He's the boss man, yes.
What crazy movie.
All right.
He dresses so casual.
Okay, Sandy. All you have to do is match one celebrity, and you will have won your second game. Nanook the Eskimo said, "It's tough living in an igloo. Not only are the walls made out of ice, but inside even the blank is made out of ice."
The toilet.
Sergeant, there is hope. The trip may not have been in vain. She said, the toity. What do you say?
I'm sorry. I'm afraid your hope just went in the toity.
Toity! Come on down, my dear Sandy, and stand over there on the adhesive tape while I shake his hand here. A pleasure meeting you.
It's been fun.
And we've got marvelous gifts for you, Sergeant. Sergeant, you're walking out when I'm talking to you. What is that? Oh, there we go. Goodbye, Sergeant. So now, Sandy, you picked up another $100. You got $700, and now you come to the big money. And shall we get right to it?
Yes.
We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Unblank. Remember, you get $500 if you match the answer they gave most frequently, $250 if you match their second most frequently given response, and $100 for the third most popular. And you can call on anyone you want here for a little help.
Okay, Richard.
Well, I know you are a married lady, but I...
Get ready to match the stars. Gary Murgon, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Rudd, Susan Sullivan, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Guillafont as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rammer!
Would you believe there is a moth flying around back there?
A moth?
A moth. Or as what's-his-name said in the movie, a myth.
A myth.
You didn't hurt it, did you?
No, I tried to, but it got
you
away.
You sure it's not a fairy?
Kill that moth there.
No. What are you looking at me for? That voice coming out of this head, are you kidding?
You're going to stave the whole week, are you?
Oh, I hope so.
Oh, good. Let's say hello to our two players, Sandy Fenmore and Sergeant Dick Harris over here. Now, Sandy's a current champ, right? How much money have you won? I've forgotten.
$600.
$600. And she's being challenged by the good sergeant here. And he's had both of his questions. He's a match three. And you've got one question to go. So you're kind of in the driver's seat here. All you have to do is match one, and you will have won your second game. Tune in a moment or so and see how this turns out after this match.
It was a canned whistle.
What?
It was a canned whistle.
No, it wasn't. No, wait a minute. I got to settle something here. Madam, would you do that again? Yeah, by Jove. I've got a lady whistler. One more. Now, wait a minute. Wait, we get a camera on you. I couldn't believe my ears. Is now pinball blank.
Machine.
Machine is her answer. All right, she says pinball machine will match you with the $5,000. Richard, what do you say to that?
Do you remember the film with Elton John? The big hit record, too.
What was that called?
Pinball Wizard.
Oh, yeah.
Because you need a machine.
You got it. Sister's very happy, isn't she? Bouncing around that seat there.
Okay, you got $6,200.
I don't have $6,000.
Yes, you do have $6,000. Indeed, you do. And while you and your sister are celebrating, we're going to spin these messages for America. How do you do? Listen, would you like to greet another player now?
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah. Let's say hello to Lynn Refkin. Where are you from, Lynn, and all that?
I'm from Palos Verdes, where I sell real estate. I'm married and have a 7-year-old daughter.
Anything else?
Kokosi. Does that mean anything to you?
Kokosi.
Right.
Kakosi.
Oh, is that it?
Yeah, it means how are you?
That's
in
right.
In Serbo-Croatian. You speak that language?
No.
Obviously.
Another
someone
one
puts you up to that,
very
huh?
little.
Yeah, well, I thank you for asking. Okay, here we go. Bing, there you go. Lynn, you may have A or B.
A.
A. Okay, Lynn.
I got it.
Nice that she thought of it.
That, I think that's marvelous. The answer to that.
Rude and
Kokosi. Kokosi. Kokosi, that means how are you? And the answer
Kokoban?
Is Dobro hvala lijepa. I'm well, thank
que
you.
Que pasa?
Nah, shut up. Now listen to this, Lynn. Bernie is such a super salesman.